So exits, I'll just add to what Nandini mentioned earlier. So realistically speaking, in the startup world, most exits will come from your next round of money. Okay. And that next round of money typically will only come when a VC wants to clean up the cap table. Till that point of time, they don't want to give anyone exits. You know why? Why should they have good money chase going into non-productive use? So if I'm coming in my first angel, in my first VC round, I spend half the money just buying out the existing investors. That means the money is not going to productive use, right? So very rarely do in the first round you get an exit. You'll typically get an exit on a second round or second level financing when the business model is proven and the guy wants to consolidate the cap table. Now, we talked about active hires. Now, active hires is when things are not good. Okay, that's not a good word. Or there's an IP sale. Those two things happen when things are not good. You say, chalo, talent hai, you have 20 people who understand delivery business. You know, you won't have to train. It'll save you cost of training, stuff like that. One of the things which I find most people in the Indian startup system, I've now started looking at more, is the value, sorry, is the power of corporate development teams. I actually am motivating all the companies invested in to start looking at the corporate development team who is going to buy you out. And this is now suddenly you're seeing a rising trend, where it was Horlicks being bought for a large amount of money, but even within startup ecosystems. Look at the Bombay Shaving Company, some other examples. Or Beardco, for example, Manico bought it. You know, realistically speaking, an IPO is a very long one. So it's an angel investor hanging on in a company until the IPO time, I've never heard of that. Doesn't happen. Okay, what happened in exit? All the good things happen on exit. Not all the good things do not happen in exit. See, when the cookie crumbles and there's money on the table, everybody gets greedy. And it's your greed versus his greed. So then you start looking back, you know, SSC mein kya likha tha, clause 13, part section 6 mein. Kya hone wala? And you know what? At that point of time, that SSA which you spent so much time laboring over is probably toilet paper. Because your startup has come to a stage where they need money. They have 2 months of money left in the bank. The new investor comes in, he knows that. He likes the business. Business is doing great. Metrics are good. He says, boss, I want to give you money, but these are my needs. Now, in that time, when you have, you're between a frying pan and a fire, you are still trying to negotiate. So you have to handle that well. And that's when you use a third party, someone you say, Nandri, help me out. Because to mediate karo thoda, you know. So that's second thing I'm gonna go into is cleaning up the cap table, negotiating. Now there are always two, three valuation negotiations. One is primary valuation, one is secondary valuation. So the new investor comes in, he's not gonna come to you and say, boss, I've invested money in this value, this company. I will give the same value. No. He's not that much of a nice guy. He's going to come to you and say, I'm giving money at that value. I'm going to give you money at this value. You take it or leave it. I'll give you an example, real example, I'll tell you later. Also, Nani talked about this. Sometimes the founders do not want the secondary. You know why? Because founder now likes you. You've been an investor for 2 years. You're like, sir, you're like, bhai, you're like, didi, whatever. He doesn't know this unknown new guy coming in. And he wants you there because he thinks you will mediate, you will be the middle block. Now you own 20%, he owns 40%, the new guy owns 40%. He wants you there. Now I honestly would like to get out. I'll take whatever exit I get when I can get it. But sometimes the founders are the ones who actually are blocking it. You have to really read between the lines. And the lead hygiene factors, you'll look at preemptive rights, board seats, IRR clauses. You'll fight for those. If you get them, great. If you don't, then you know it is what it is. Little different. So I just talk you three companies what has happened very quickly since I love to do Q&A. Company A, question is when should you quit? Okay. So company A was a real company I invested. Year one, company raised 1 crore rupees, 6 crore post money valuation. Very reasonable valuation, great founder, great team, great everything. Year 2, they raised 5 crores on a 25 crore post money valuation. Fresh money coming at 5 crore rupees on a 25 crore valuation. I'm like, wow, 6 to 25, fantastic exit. Investor comes and says, That's very good. But old investors, we will do a secondary offer at 15 crore valuation. Now, I'm sitting there thinking, it's been exactly 14 months. I'm getting on paper nearly 3x on my money. Plus, I'll pay short-term capital gains tax on it, which is not that much. Should I take it or should I stay for the long haul? So I took it. Some of my friends didn't take it. 2 years now, what? Now, 2 years later after this, today the company is valued at about actually over 60 crores. But the new investors who come in at that valuation have not given any of the old investors an exit option. So not every investor gives you the exit option. The guy who came in on 25 crore valuation gave old investors an exit option. The guy who's coming to this company now at a 50-60 crore valuation has not given anyone an exit option. Matlab ki ab tum 3-2 saal aur baithe rahoge. And then business might fail, you don't know. So you have to really think this through. Company 2 founder quit. Very famous, well, company Bangalore based, lots of famous investors. The who's who. I also invested. I said, why you look kar rahe hain? There must have done due diligence. I also invested. You also invested. Very good. First, monthly reporting fine, everything coming fine. Great. One fine day the founder says, yeah, I was getting a crore rupees plus earlier in salary. I'm getting pretty less than 20 lakhs now. I can't do this. I'm going to go back to my corporate job. I'm moving back to Silicon Valley. He's quit. Like no left, no right, nothing. One fine day he got up and said, I'm going. It's actually happened. Company 3 is another interesting case study going on. The founder says, so telling us, I'm raising money on a 5 times the valuation we gave, I'm going to raise $2 million, $2 million. I said, wow, wonderful, do it. The VC called up and says, you know, can you send me a copy of the audited financials? I'm like, yeah, to August file nahi hota. So these are actual real life delusional people who think they're going to go and raise money on some ridiculously high valuation when you're sitting in the month of December and your August financials are being filed. So these are 3 examples. The successful ones I gave right up front. So I think my best exit was a 3x in 7 months. Overall portfolio wise, I'm probably at, I think I'm on average, I've kind of doubled my money every 2 years. So not bad. So I'll just give you, share that format with you once very quickly. You have the Excel. So what I've done now is we've given every company investing a simple spreadsheet on MIS. There's a complicated MIS, there's a basic MIS. And I can send you copies, Nandini can also send you copies of this. So my MIS is like simple. You start in the month, cash in bank. What you did the entire month long, end of the month, cash in bank. That's all I want to know. You know, how much money you start the month with, how much money you end in the month with. And I want to know all the major expenditures on it. So we have a little format for that. I'll also show you a copy of the Mumbai Angels portfolio reporting. So the portfolio reporting will measure, will depend, will be different from every company based on what they're doing. You know, so you'll have to identify key metrics. Because if I am at the beer cafe, for example, my key metric is how many people came, what is my revenue per square foot, what is my revenue per person. So I want to know that, right? And how many inventory turnover tables are that? That's for that business. So what I'm now spending time doing is with a professional firm, identifying, this is basic one, right? Opening. Cash in bank, total revenue, main operations, the business needs, salaries. That's what I told you. So I always put in founder salary, business development marketing salary. Now if your founder salary is over 50% of all salaries, that's not a good thing, right? Core team support salary, option support salary, sales salary, stipend, tech salary, bonus incentives. So I want to see salaries based on this format. I want to know how much you're spending on tech people, how much founders are getting, how much your core team is getting, and how much your sales people are getting. Mota. Right? Go back to the good. So this comes over here, same technology cost, event cost, marketing cost, whatever, indirect expenses. Whatever, and then at the end of the month again you have net gain loss and closing balance. Very simple. And now I've decided, started giving this to founders upfront. You please put those, because it's the first step of knowing is that person financially proven or not. You just open the. So this is an actual MIS reporting which happens every quarter from a company book events. I'm on the board. Had them raise the first round. I think that was 6-8 crore valuation. 3 years later, they raised 140 crore valuation. So, actually, quarter loan utilized. Scroll down. So, marketing data. You can see metrics, actual. No one's thing. Number of inquiries, marketing spend, business update. What they did. Product tech update, marketing update. And the future plan. This closed. They raised the 10%. They raised the money next round. So you know, a lot of people don't realize that when a VC is going to invest in a company, he expects the founders to have very robust MIS. Which is why I got back to the first stage. You know, you have to know your numbers. I think that's basically about it. Happy to answer any questions.